You ready?
I know. Well, wait. Before we introduce Steve Santagati, the reason these women are going crazy, Johnny Depp, Jesse James, Charlie Sheen, what do these guys have in common? They are all former bad boys. Former bad boys. Right now, they seem to be domesticated.
But
we have domesticated them. We have tamed them.
How about these dudes, though? Like Tommy Lee and Kid Rock, Colin Farrell. They don't show any signs of being tamed at all. So, I mean, with or without a woman on their arm. Raising the question, can a bad boy ever truly be tamed? So we hit the streets of New York City and ask, can you tame a bad boy?
Bad boys, probably because you're looking to rebel.
I think women like bad boys because they're more exciting.
I see a lot of women getting into bad boys because a lot of them are soft inside when it comes to women.
I've tried and failed to tame a bad boy. When I start dating someone who's a bad boy, I pretend I'm spontaneous. I'm like, oh, I'll do whatever. And then I realize that that sort of doesn't work in terms of trying to like change their opinion or anything.
Bad guys, they can't be tamed. Yeah, I think you just have to know what you want in life. You either want a bad guy and just accept that it's just not going to work out, or go for the good guy in the end. Hopefully, good guys will finish last.
This is such a good topic. Yeah. All right, so here to give us the unabridged truth about bad boys, and if they are, in fact, tameable, is the author of The Manual and self-proclaimed bad boy himself, Steve Santagati.
Hey, Steve.
My old buddy.
Look at his t-shirt. Bad boy.
Bad boys finish first. All right, so here's the deal. Bad boys, when I think of bad boy, I think my first thought is player. Guy that doesn't settle down with women.
No, that's a big misconception.
What's a bad boy then?
A bad boy loves women. Players just care about the numbers. They don't care how they seduce you. They just want to get you in bed. Bad boys actually love women. We want to understand you. We want to get inside your head.
But you love a lot of women.
We like different
types. At the same time.
No. Different types of women.
I mean, not like literally.
No, different types. Guys go through different stages when they're quote-unquote bad boys. Basically, the thing is, we're unapologetically guys. We're always being bashed on television for being who we are. And in magazine stuff, your pigs, your dogs, we're all of that. And we love it.
I don't think there's anything wrong with that.
There's nothing.
But if you're a woman out there right now watching, and you've decided, okay, I do love bad boys, and I want one.
Okay.
And I want to keep him. Is there a certain age of a bad boy where you're keepable? Like in the 30s? Like 20-year-old?
No, he's right. No, there's different stages. When you're 24, 28, you're at your peak. Ladies, if you're going to go out with a guy who's a bad boy at 28, you better have your game face on and take off the gloves, because he can't do anything wrong at that stage. As we get older, we start to think, you know what? I've gone through this type of woman, that type
of
woman. Now I want to settle with someone that I can talk to and hang out with. I'm still going to be naughty, and I'm never giving
up. Tell us how to keep a bad boy then.
Number one thing as a woman, bottom line, is you have to be culpable. You have to take care of yourself, looking sexy, always keeping pretty and stuff like that. You have to, because we're visual creatures. That's the laws of nature.
So
that's the law. That's how it works. I'm not
kidding. Steve, I better go out to the
office. I've heard you use this argument. I go out in my sweatpants all the time, sweatshirt, stains on
it. All right, well, that's a different conversation. But if you're single, ladies, if you're single, Mike's in the audience.
Someone's trying to get sexy here.
No, you're sexy. You guys were already doing naughty things to me in the audience. It's perfect.
Oh, yeah.
Number one rule, done. You're all checked that one off.
You're all culpable. That's sexy.
Come on, Wayne.
The second thing you have to do, you ready, is you have to lay down the law. I am used to, as all bad boys and all men know this, especially these guys laughing in the front row, we will get away with murder.
Yeah.
If we can jump on the couch with our shoes on, we're going to do it. So you have to lay down the law right in the beginning, and we'll respect that because most women don't make us do that.
How about confidence?
Confidence is part of being sexy. When you walk into a room, you have to have that thing inside of you, even if you're faking it that day because you feel so insecure.
Oh, that's so true.
It's so true.
So true.
He's like, you know, like, I feel sexy. I can have anybody in here. And you know what? Men, because we're animals, will pick up on it.
Hey, Steve, but then in the book you said if you're a woman, don't fall into patterns. What do you mean?
That means spontaneous. Like, what happens, because we all work and we have certain patterns in our life, get up, have our coffee, go to work, go to the gym, have a meal, have sex, go to bed, or watch our show. Okay, so you have sex, then you eat, then you have sex again. But my point is that guys,
that
especially bad boys, because we're kids at heart, we want to not be able to predict what you're going to do next, because we've been with so many women that we know what they're going to do, that it's boring.
Yeah.
So if we don't know what you're going to do, it's going to be like literally having a domesticated wild animal where, he's calm now or she's calm now, but God knows
it's going to happen. So a challenge. You need a challenge.
Yeah, but it's something that's tacit, but you just have to feel it.
But like that woman in the piece, she says, you know, I know that he's a bad boy, and he wants me to be spontaneous. And she says, so She was faking her spontaneity.
Right. She had the right idea, but she didn't know how to.
Well, she'll never get it. She's just not a spontaneous woman.
Well, you never know. I mean, yes, we can all learn. What I've done, you guys, honestly, everything in the book, it's a skill. It's no different than driving, but no one takes the time to do it. We all know about Britney's career and this person and that person and how to, program our DVD player and do TV and everything, but no one takes time to learn about the opposite sex. And it's really important because that's ultimately what's going to make you happy or sad.
I have to say, your book has really good points in it. I mean, you're always good to talk to because you do give the bad boy side.
And the truth.
And, yeah, you do give the truth.
I have a question. Yes. With older bad boys, how do you get to give them up their reckless ways, such as bicycle riding and motorcycles without helmets, particularly motorcycles?
Wait a minute, a bad boy on a bicycle?
No.
Hey.
Oh, I'm bad.
You mean a motorcycle?
Well, no, I switched it to motorcycles, but all the without the helmets and reckless driving.
You know what? Next time you're near him, whack him in the back of the head. You see how that feels? If you fall off your motorcycle at even 20 miles an hour, you're really going to get hurt and you're going to be useless.
Julia, do you think this sounds like too much hard work, though?
No,
I don't think so. Because I fell in love with the bad boy. I don't know if he's a bad boy, but...
No, he's a real guy. I was talking
guys,
to her
yeah, guys are men are...
He's a real guy. He's a
guy's
great guy.
Yeah,
and he's got an edge to him, believe me. His yes is yes and his no is a no. He deals with wild animals. But here's a little... No, for a living.
Not talking about Juliet, you mean?
Oh, wham!
He's got claws. All right, so listen. So here's the top, number one secret. After you get the bad boy and you do all this stuff, you make him your best friend. And you know why? Because I'll cheat on a girl, but I'm not going to be bad to my male friends. So if I feel like you're an honest to goodness friend, like I can tell you things and I can confide in you, and you're not going to judge me or be critical or be reactive, you got me.
That's Steve got a good book here, man.
Thank you, my
friend. And it's available in bookstores, by the way, everywhere. So make sure you go out and get it. It's called The Manual. Steve Santy.